But it is not over yet. Shaylin Bourne and Victor Kraatz of Canada, the reigning Canadian champions. The music, High Society Overture. As in the other disciplines, if you're in the top three heading into the final portion of the competition and you win this portion, you're the overall champion.
Now look at the difference with this couple from Grishuk and Platov. Look at the fast, intricate footwork, but long, sweeping low edges. Very gentle kind of ice dance, as opposed to the power and the strength and the passion of Grishuk and Platov. Quite a different style of dancing. Now, look at the knees. Wonderful move.
Year ago in their home country, and if you think that upsets don't happen in the world of ice dancing, remember Grishuk and Platov themselves at the 94 Olympics.
And look at how much more of a popular, romantic, modern dance than the very ethnic dance of Grishuk and Platov. Wonderful movement. Beautiful depth, beautiful low, soft, supple knees. There's a little hydroblading. I tell you, there's a popularity about this dance that's going to be very impressively received by this audience. How do you like that?
I see Lynn's mother, Peggy Skipper, in the audience. Smile on her face. Why not?
I'll tell you, for the first time, I had felt that Grishuk and Platov were challenged by this dance.
Remember Krylov and Oksyonikov in second place. Shaylin Bourne and Victor Kraatz defeated them at the Champion Series final a couple weeks ago. We'll have their marks when we come back. In Lausanne, Shaylin Bourne and Victor Kraatz following their championship free skate.
And really a very beautiful dance. But an example of one of the elements of ice dancing that they began is this hydroblading. Very unusual and very difficult move. Quite wonderful, isn't it?
Now they have challenged Krylova and Ovsyannikov, who are in second place. And you mentioned you don't think Grishuk and Platov have been pressured this much in a long, long time, Dick. They lead.
Well, I highly doubt that they will defeat Grishuk and Platov, but I certainly think that the program was not as difficult or as technically demanding by any means. Here you can see the marks are lower here in technical merit.
And they anxiously await the second set of marks, which will tell the story. For presentation, there they are.
It was just a very pleasant dance. It was really beautiful to watch, enjoyable. The difficulty, not as great.
And they come up short and end up in third place. So Grishuk and Platov continue to dominate in the world of ice dancing. For the second straight year, Krylova and Ovsyannikov capture the silver. Bourne and Kraatz again the bronze. And Punsalan and Swallow, the best finish by an American couple since 1990. Right now, Leslie Visser is standing by with the Americans. Leslie?
Terry, it was their first standing ovation at the Worlds, and well-deserved. Great job by both of you. Liz, to you first. Maybe people in America don't understand what sixth place is. Why is that impressive?
Well, it was great for us this year because we were ahead of two teams that we hadn't beaten before at any championships, let alone Worlds, so it was a big movement for us.
And what did you come here wanting to emphasize? What did you want to prove at these Worlds?
Well, improvement from last year, which is harder to do every time you show up for Worlds, and also we just wanted to make a big impression.
Well, that you did. And Jared, how do you think this sets you up for the Olympic Games?
It definitely shows the world that we're competitive in ice dancing. A United States couple in sixth place is great going into an Olympic year, and this is the confidence that you should have and that we now have, and it gives us a momentum, and it gives us a great shot at medals next year, I think.
Well, you have a lot of confidence and you have a lot of support. Congratulations to you. Back to you, Terry.
Well, Oksana Grishuk and Yevgeny Platov can't take it to the next level. There isn't one. They become the first dance team to win four consecutive world titles since 88 and the seventh to do it overall. They join Leslie now.
Terry, I don't think Carl Lewis could keep up with these guys. They are so fast and so powerful. Oksana, congratulations to you. What happened there with your skirt?
I don't know. I used to skate in pants for the practice, and this is a new dress for this competition, and it was, I guess, a little bit too long. But it doesn't bother me.
No, it didn't seem to bother many people. You've won so many medals. What is the challenge for you skating now?
We're looking forward to compete on next Olympic Games in 98 next year, so that was a lot of pressure for us. It's a very important competition here.
And what do you think you did well this evening?
Yeah, we did very well, and we're happy with that, and, you know, just one mistake because it's skirt, but it's okay. You know, we didn't fail, and we skated really great tonight.
Yes, you did. Congratulations to you both. Back to you, Terry.
Leslie.